just love being in the office late at night when everyone else has gone home. It's so quiet. Because I love the way I look in your eyes.
Why is this door locked? Come on, open up. I lost my key months ago. Look, I don't know what you're doing in there, but if it's naughty, you better stop or let us watch.
What is your problem, Mandy?
Oh, no problem. I was just wondering why Warren's door was locked.
Warren's door was locked because I was busy cleaning up this mess on his desk.
You really shouldn't do that, Laura. You should let me do it. After all, you are the office controller, and I'm Warren's secretary.
Well, Mandy, I would be happy to let you do your job if you could do it properly.
I haven't heard any complaints from Warren.
You will.
And what is that supposed to mean? It means that you have used Warren's vacation as an excuse to do little or nothing around here.
I do my job, and I do it damn well.
That's your opinion.
Ooh, I'd like to say to that controller.
Oh, come on, Mandy. She's not that bad.
Why are you taking her side?
Laura works very hard.
Oh, is that what she trained you to say?
It's not very fair.
Look, I gotta go.
Sure. Thanks for the support.
Laura Perry represses any feelings that disturb the calm waters of her life. But love's currents are strong, and the undertow of obsession is hard to fight.
My schedule is so tight, we better plan on working the weekend.
Both days?
Is that a problem?
No, I just had a date on Sunday.
Well, Karen, your love life has to come second when you're serious about your career. Nobody knows that better than I do.
I've always thought it's too bad, you know, that Warren's married. The way you two get along and all.
Both Warren and I toyed with the idea before he got married.
What happened?
Helene chased him down with the single-minded determination of an aging bimbo desperate for a rich husband. Men, they know what they want, but not what they need.
Don't you ever wish it was different?
No, never. I've worked long and hard to get where I am. My job, I love my independence, I love the money. I'm happy.
Miss Perry's office. Okay, thanks. Warren's here.
What about Miller?
No, she's just had that new baby. She'll never put in the hours.
How are my guppies?
Your fantails are hardly guppies, but they're fine. And so are your plants.
Thanks for looking after them.
Warren, you haven't even said. How were the islands?
Stormy. Inside and out. So much so that Helene chose to stay behind.
For how long?
I don't know. Maybe forever.
Warren? What happened?
Mandy?
That's all right. We're all family here. I don't know. I think I've been punishing myself and Elaine for years, and all because of a simple mistake. One wrong choice.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. I've been a jerk. Now, the answer to my problems has been sitting in front of my face for a long time. I've just never seen it, until lately.
Enough of that. Laura, my body tells me it's way past dinner time in the islands. What say we order from that Chinese place? Just like the old days.
You mean the one with the apocalyptic fortune cookies?
That's it.
I think the number's in my office. I'll be right back.
Yes, and an order of mushu pork and plenty of fortune cookies. Great, thank you.
Warren wants the sales figures for the last 2 weeks.
Oh, that's okay, Karen. I'll get them. You might as well go on home.
But what about the meeting?
It's all right. I'll bring you up to speed next week.
Okay, thanks. Miss Perry's office. Oh, I'm sorry. I completely forgot. Look, I'll fax them to you tonight. Just one more, please.
You are amazing. I adore you.
Keep it up. I like hearing something besides, get me a cup of coffee, will you, Mandy, honey?
I never said that.
Oh.
Don't make fun of poor Laura.
And how exactly did you get rid of your good friend tonight?
Poor Laura isn't my place. Feeding the guppies.
This is for you. Well, this is for me. And my Warren. I hope you're having a good time, Helene. Because I know I'm going to. Don't tell me you're surprised to see me, Warren.
Surprised you are to see me, Laura. I can guess that. I'm not as stupid as you've always said. Bimbo. Isn't that what you've always called me?
I'm sorry. Helene, I'm so embarrassed.
I think pathetic is a better word. You know, I thought that I was coming in here to shoot Warren and his lover, but instead... Instead, I find you practicing to be a bimbo.
Well, I'm leaving.
As if Warren would ever want to touch you.
Stop.
Warren thinks you are a very efficient machine.
Shut up.
You have stabbed me in the back for years, just waiting for a chance to get at my husband. A chance to prove that you're not the miserable, frigid little...
I feel so responsible. If only I'd gone there later or stayed longer, maybe Helene would still be.
You shouldn't blame yourself, Laura.
So you fed the fish and left at what time?
Around 8. You've asked me that 5 times, Detective. I do want to cooperate, but I have a lot of work to do.
And I have a dead body and no sign of forced entry.
You're not suspecting Warren?
No. The parking guy confirms he left around 11.
Well, then who?
Right now, everybody. It's only a matter of time.
Would you please stop that sniffling?
I'm sorry. It's just all so terrible. I mean, who could do such a thing?
You heard him. It was a crime of passion, obviously. Committed by someone who's emotionally unstable. You know, Karen, I didn't want to say anything with him here, but... there has been something very wrong in this office.
What do you mean?
Well, Warren has come to me any number of times complaining that some of his things were missing.
What sort of things?
Oh, unimportant little things. A date book. That old pipe of his that he used to smoke. Well, think about it, Karen. Who's over-emotional to the point of being unstable in this office? Who's constantly throwing herself at Warren? Flaunting herself in those short, tight skirts?
Mandy?
She's obviously in love with him. She's obsessed with him.
That's impossible.
Then why did she overreact this morning to the news of Helene's death? She was hysterical. She had to go home.
She was just upset, like everybody else.
Stop thinking with your feelings.
Laura?
Mandy, dear, how are you?
I'm a mess. How else would I be? Poor Helene.
I brought some things from the office that need your attention.
Laura.
Mandy, we have to be strong for Warren.
I suppose you're right. I just can't look at anything right now.
Poor Mandy. It's hard, I know, for all of us. I know what we need. How about a good stiff drink? Well, don't look so surprised. I'm not as much of a prig as you think. Where do you keep it?
On the table. Make mine a double.
Good idea. This has all been such a nightmare. But it'll
It'll all be over soon.
The funeral's on Monday.
You've spoken to Warren?
Yeah, a couple of times. Oh, poor baby's really losing his mind over this.
Don't you worry about Warren. We'll take care of him. That's our job. Men, they know what they want, but not what they need.
Oh, I don't know. Warren's usually pretty clear about both. Shouldn't have had that drink. I haven't eaten all day.
Why don't you just lie back?
That's not a bad idea.
Everything's going to be all right. Warren called me last night at home. He needs me to go through these insurance papers for the lawyers. You are incredible. Oh, I'm happy to do it for him.
Why didn't you leave it for Mandy to do?
Oh, she was so hysterical yesterday. Who knows when she'll be back?
Oh, the doctors say she'll be fine in a day or two. I was worried about her last night when she didn't answer her phone. So I went over to her apartment. The superintendent let me in. She was unconscious. An overdose.
How tragic. You see, I told you the poor girl was unbalanced.
I also found that collection of Warren's things in her apartment.
It's all so sad.
The same things I told the police that you kept in your desk drawer.
You're mistaken. You're obviously not thinking clearly.
Stop telling me what to think and how to feel.
Karen, control yourself. You are becoming hysterical.
I am not hysterical. I'm furious.
I don't think that this is an appropriate place for such discussion.
No. I used to be afraid of you. And then for a while there, I actually felt sorry for you.
I have so much work to do.
But now I just hate you.
Warren is going to expect these by this afternoon.
Warren is at the hospital with Mandy. He's been there most of the night. He and Mandy are lovers.
They know what they want.
Nobody wants or needs you now, Laura. Especially not Warren. Now he hates you just like everybody else.
We still have that computer memo to get out. Reports.
Laura thought that she could control her passions. She sealed them behind a wall of cold efficiency. But when the dam of repression cracked, the waves of her own obsession quickly swept her away.